Hi everyone, and welcome to this beautiful vinyasa flow with a focus on back bends. This practice includes some traditional yoga asanas that are good for practitioners of all levels, with certain modifications if necessary. Remember to focus on your own breathing and how your body feels. Let's come together in a standing position. Close your eyes and take a few deep breaths. With the next inhale, sweep your arms up as you lengthen. Exhale, release them down. One more time as you follow your breathing. Inhale, reach through the arms up. Deep exhale as you fold all the way forward. Inhale up to standing. Exhale, dive forward. Inhale, come up, reach arms up, interlace your fingers and find length. Now place your hands behind your head, tuck chin to chest and start to round into your back as you fold forward. Inhale, lift through chest and chin up, stick your booty up, squeeze shoulder blades together. Continue with a few more of the spinal waves, bringing all the awakening energy into your back. As you round your back, apply some pressure with your hands, and as you lift up, find space across the chest as you squeeze the shoulder blades together and open through the elbows wide. Beautiful. Slowly roll up to standing. Place your hands onto your hips. Lift through your heart up and extend into standing back bend. Root through your feet into the mat, engage your glutes and find space through the front side of your body. Exhale, soften your knees and fold all the way forward. Let's repeat this two more times. Inhale into the back bend. Exhale, standing forward fold, bend the knees. One more time with your breath. Inhale up to standing. Bring your feet hip distance apart. Extend your left arm over to the right into a side bend. Back to center. Repeat it a few more times. As you do this, engage your glutes and your inner thighs. Try to keep your chest open wide. Pause in a side bend. Well done. Let's do this on the other side. Reaching through the right arm all the way to the left and back to the center. One more time. And hold your side bend here. Slightly pull the stomach in, squeeze the inner thighs, lift through the chest up. Well done. Step to the front of your mat. Inhale, lift through the arms up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, plank. Inhale, deep. Exhale, chest and chin to floor. Inhale, lift up, cobra. Keep the shoulders down. Exhale, downward facing dog. hold it here as you focus on your breathing and as you create space and length through the entire backside of your body. Exhale as you bring your knees down, tabletop position. We'll continue with a few cat and cow movements as you follow your breathing, your own speed. Inhale, chest and tailbone up. Exhale, round the back, push the floor away. Every single time, looking for as deep of an arch through the back as you can find. Keep your back rounded and sit your hips towards the child's pose. We'll continue with a few of the spinal waves between child's pose and your tabletop position. So as you shift forward round your back, as you shift back, lift through the chest up. So round the back, chin to chest, lift through the chin up, stick the booty out on the way into the child's pose. Moving slowly like a wave. Place your knees to the sides of the mat. Walk your hands farther forward, arriving into the puppy pose position. Now a few cat and cow movements here, focusing on your hips and lower to mid back as we tuck and untuck the tailbone. Perfect. Tuck the tailbone and hold it here, melting the chest down, contracting through the core. And now release as you soften the chest all the way down towards the mat, arriving into a more traditional puppy pose. Inhale, slowly come out. And lower down onto the mat for the hovering sphinx pose. Bring your elbows underneath your shoulders, or if necessary, farther forward. Hover your elbows slightly above the floor. Spread the fingers and pull your hands back towards your feet. Keep the shoulders down onto your back and create the space all across the chest, all across the collarbones as you lift through the heart up. Exhale as you release. We'll continue with the full locust pose with your fingers interlaced behind your back. With the next exhale, lift your chest and legs up. Look for a strong muscular engagement through the entire back side of your body. Engage your glutes, your hamstrings, draw the shoulder blades together, and then release. Good, we'll go for a scorpion twist in this prone position. So extend your arms to the sides, palms facing down. Now flip your left foot all the way towards your right hand or as close as you can reach. If available, you can grab the right hand onto the left foot, finding a beautiful stretch through the hip flexors, a twist through your back. Be mindful of this position. Connect to your breathing. Exhale, return onto the tummy. And let's change the sides. Extend your arms down, palms facing down. Flip your right foot towards your left hand. Engage into the glutes, into the hamstrings of the right leg to find more space through the front of your hip. Extend your right arm out to the side. Slowly release, place the hands next to the chest. Inhale, lift up in cobra, shoulders down, looking for space. And exhale, downward facing dog. We'll continue with the quad stretch. So with the next inhale, lift through the right leg up. Exhale, step it through. Bring the left knee down. Grab hold of the left foot with your right hand. You can go for any modification of the quad stretch that feels good to you. Sometimes I prefer to lower down all the way onto the left forearm. Your intention is to sink the hips down towards the mat, to pull the heel all the way towards you and lift through the chest up. Release the clasp and let's come into a lizard lunge and hold it here. Inhale all the way back and up into the downward facing dog. And we'll change the sides. Inhale, lift through the left leg up. Exhale, step it through. Bring the right knee down. Grab hold of the right foot with your left hand. Sink your hips down, lift through the chest up. If you prefer, you can lower down onto the right forearm. Hold it wherever you feel the best stretch for you. Let go of the clasp and come into the lizard lunge position on the left side. Try to release all the unnecessary tension. Soften your hips down. Relax your shoulders. Connect to your breath. Slowly come back up into the plank. Exhale, chaturanga. And lower all the way down onto the mat. We'll continue with an active variation of a bow pose. So first we will not clasp the hands onto the feet. Now bend the knees, lift through the toes up, lift through the chest up as you reach your arms towards your feet. And then softly grab your hands onto your feet. Press the ankle into your hands and open through the chest as we hold the bow pose. Exhale, release. Place the hands next to the chest. Inhale, lift up into the cobra, chest wide open. And transition into Vajrasana, so sit the hips towards the heels. Take a deep breath before we'll continue with the camel pose. Your knees are hip distance apart. Place the hands on the hips, fingers pointing up. Extend backwards. You can choose to hold it here or might be play around with the variation of a one-sided camel as you reach one hand towards the heel. then full camel, and then extend the other arm up. Only one hand remains on the heel. Back into the camel. Whenever you feel ready, you can slowly come out from this pose, sitting the hips back to the heels. Focus on your breath. And then let's come up into one last downward facing dog to find the length through the back. With the next inhale, walk your feet forward towards your hands. Exhale, fold forward, keep the knees softly bent so that your stomach touches your thighs. Bring the hands on the opposite elbows, sway your upper body from side to side to let go of all the tension in your shoulders, your neck, hang absolutely loose. Release your hands to the floor and make your way down onto the mat. We'll finish with the seated forward fold. Inhale, reach up and lengthen. Exhale, fold forward. You can always make that seated forward fold more accessible by softening the knees or sitting up on a blanket. Keep your feet actively flexed, and with every single inhale, find the length as you reach forward. With every single exhale, surrender, soften, and release. Notice the similarity between your breathing and the ocean waves. It is peaceful, but at the same time powerful. Whenever you already come out of the stretch and roll onto your back, hug the knees into the chest, take a few moments here. If this is the end of your practice for today, extend your legs and arms down into Shavasana and allow yourself a little time to soften and relax before you continue with your day. Thank you so much for joining me for this practice. It was a pure joy and pleasure. I cannot wait to see you back on the mat. Much love and take care of yourself.